Hello everyone, welcome back to lecture 7 on automotives and vehicle dynamics. In this lecture 7, we are going to cover the topics like, first one is basics of an engine, the second one is overview of thermodynamic cycles. Before going for lecture 7, I will suggest you all to go and watch my all lectures, because to maintain a continuity while learning is most important, so that you can have a better understanding about the further topics. We look at our slides. In this slide, we look at basics of an engine. Engine provides the motive power for all various functions which the vehicle or any parts of it may be called upon to perform. Okay, it is generally that engine is a central part of a vehicle which provides motive power to various parts of a vehicle. Okay, we can also clearly say that engine is a powerhouse of a vehicle. Okay, next we look at second point. In internal combustion engine, which may be generally using either spark ignition or compression ignition type. Let us have explanation about this. In internal combustion engine, we have two types. First one is spark ignition type and second one is compression ignition type. Okay. First, let us look at spark ignition type. In spark ignition type, we are using spark plug. Okay. And the fuel we are using is petrol. And whereas in compression ignition type, we are using fuel is diesel and we are not using spark plug. Instead of spark plug, we are using fuel injectors. Okay. When we look at spark ignition, this spark ignition is also known as SI engines, whereas compression ignition, these compression ignition systems are also known as CI engines. Okay, we look at third point. However, the gas turbines has also been used successfully in certain cars. Though the cost has been a disadvantage in spite of their battery's performance compared to CI engines, compared to IC engines. Okay. In earlier days, we have used gas turbines for running of a car. Okay, but we have a disadvantage of performance of a batteries when compared to internal combustion engines. Okay, so we stop using gas turbines. In spite of gas turbines, we have increased the usage of internal combustion engines. Okay, we look at next slide. Combination of an internal combustion engine and electric motors have been successfully employed in hybrid vehicles. We all know that electric motors provide energy to an engine, and that energy this engine is storing in a flywheel and then after circulating it to all various parts of an automobile. We look at next point, that is the solar engine power systems. Solar engine power systems have also been tried, but the most promising future engines is one based on fuel cells, which would give zero emission vehicles. This solar energy power systems is mainly worked on the principle of fuel cells. Okay, when these fuel cells have been introduced in an automobile, then there would be 0% emission from a vehicle. Okay, completely pollution will be stopped. We look at next slide. Definition of thermodynamic system. Why we are discussing about thermodynamic systems at the point of engines? Because engines mainly works on the basis of thermodynamic cycles. Before going for thermodynamic cycles, we need to possess minimum amount of knowledge about how does a thermodynamic system works. Okay, let us have a look about it. A thermodynamic system is a specific space or a microscopic region in the universe whose state can be expressed in terms of pressure, temperature and volume. It is clear, right? This thermodynamic system is a specific space, okay, that specific space in the universe. This thermodynamic system is expressed only in terms of pressure, temperature and volume. Okay, we look at next slide. In this slide, we are going to look at types of systems in a thermodynamics are as follows. Okay, generally we have three types in this. We look at each of them. First one is open system, second one is closed system, and third one is isolated system. We look at first one, open system. It allows energy as well as mass to flow in and out of it. Okay, this open system allows energy and mass to flow in and out of it. Okay, we look at second one, that is closed system. It only allows energy, work and heat to transfer, to be transferred across its boundaries. Okay, second, that is closed system, it allows only heat and work to be transferred across the boundaries. Okay, across the boundaries means it is not allowing inside the system, whereas in open system, heat and mass is allowed inside the system to flow and allowed to flow outside of the system. Okay, whereas in closed system, it is not allowing inside of the system and it is not allowing the amount of energy present inside the system to go out. Okay, in this, it is only allowing heat, it is only allowing work or heat to be transferred across the boundaries, that means outside of the system. Okay, we look at third one, that is isolated system. Neither mass nor energy is allowed to interact with it. Okay, isolated system is one which is a entirely type of closed one. Okay, which neither allows mass or energy to interact with it. Okay, hope you all understand these three systems. We look at next type, next slide. In this slide, we are going to look at different processes in a thermodynamics. Generally, the change of state of a system is depend upon the different processes used in a thermodynamic cycles. Okay, so here I was considering a basics of four processes. These four, depending upon these four processes only, I was going to explain in next slides. In fact, n number of processes are there, but for as of now, I was going through only four processes. Let us have a look at four processes. Let us have a look at first one, that is isobaric process, in which the pressure is kept constant. Okay, isobaric means one thing has to strike in our mind, that pressure has to be kept constant. Next, we have isochoric process. Isochoric process means volume has to be kept constant. Okay, and next we have isothermal process. We can clearly understand that thermal means temperature. Temperature has to be kept constant. And next we have adiabatic process, in which the heat transfer is zero. Okay, I'm not going into depth about this all processes, all those things. I'm just explaining the basics. Okay, depending upon these basics only, I'm going to explain in next slides. Okay, we look at next slide. That is, in this slide, let us have a difference between four-stroke petrol engine and four-stroke diesel engine. This slide is the most important slide in this lecture 7, because depending upon this slide only the next slides will be designed. Okay, if you have understand this slide, you can clearly understand the next cycles. Okay, firstly we look at difference between this. Okay, the left side one is four stroke petrol engine and the right side one is four stroke diesel engine. Okay, firstly we look at construction difference between petrol engine and diesel engine. Okay, firstly I have said, you know, in slide 2 I think so, we have discussed that petrol engines are those which we can also call as SI engines or spark plug engines, right? Whereas diesel engines are those CI engines, compression ignition engines, right? That's what we are going to look at a brief about this. Okay, first we look at construction of a petrol engine. Okay, this is let us assume this as an portion from an engine. Okay, first we need to assume that the outer walls of a cylinder. Okay, these are the outer walls of a cylinder. Okay, these outer walls of a cylinder is further named as a TDC and BDC. Okay, TDC full form is top dead center and BDC full form is bottom dead center. Okay, the place where spark plug is arranged in a petrol engine, that portion of cylinder is known as top dead center. Okay, and the place where piston will move downwards and stop and return to its original position, bottom dead center, that is this one. Okay, this position is known as bottom dead center. Okay, here you can clearly look at inlet valve. Okay, this is the inlet valve. Okay, and this is a spark plug. Spark plug is arranged exactly at the center of cylinder. Okay, and this is the outlet valve. Okay, inlet valve, spark plug and outlet valve. Left side arrangement is inlet valve and middle arrangement is spark plug and right side arrangement is outlet valve. Okay, between the two cylinders, between the walls of a cylinder, we have a piston arrangement. Okay, this piston and crankshaft is connected by the help of connecting rod, this one. Okay, I hope everything is clear, right? And now we look at four stroke in a petrol engine. Okay, four stroke has been further divided into part A, part B, part C, part B. Okay, let us consider it as four strokes. Okay, part A is one stroke, one part B stroke, two part C stroke, three and part D stroke, four. Okay, and we look at what happens in stroke one. Okay, stroke one is known as suction stroke. Okay, piston will be moving downwards, that is inside the cylinder piston will be moving downwards to the BDC, that is bottom dead center. Okay, then the amount of fuel plus air mixture will be entering into the cylinder. Okay, fuel plus air mixture is already present in carburetor. Okay, from that carburetor we'll be getting that fuel plus air mixture into this cylinder when this piston moves bottom dead center position. Okay, inside the cylinder. Okay, then this is the first stroke. Okay, and then we look at second stroke, that is compression stroke. When suction stroke happens, then the inlet valve will be open and outlet valve will be closed. After completion of that suction stroke, when we go for second stroke, that is compression stroke, then both the valves will be closed, okay, and piston will move towards TDC, that is from bottom dead center to top dead center. Then whatever the amount of air plus fuel mixture will be there, that will be compressed, okay, and this is stroke 2. And in stroke 3, whatever the thing is going to be happen, in stroke 3 also inlet valve will be closed and outlet valve will be also closed, and the spark, small amount of spark will be ignited from by the help of spark plug, okay. Then whatever the amount of fuel plus air mixture present inside the cylinder will be ignited, okay. This stroke is also known as expand stroke or working stroke or power stroke, okay. By the help of this stroke only vehicle is getting power, okay. This is the third stroke. In third stroke also inlet and exhaust valve will be closed, and then next we look at fourth stroke, that is exhaust stroke, okay. In third stroke, the expansion stroke, this after reaction completed, the amount of pressure created inside the cylinder, that pressure will push the piston downwards from TDC to BDC, okay. And next, in expansion stroke, that is fourth stroke, outlet valve will be opened, okay. Now the amount of mixture is converted into ash, okay. Whatever the amount of energy present inside, that present in the mixture, that is air plus fuel mixture, that we have used it, and now whatever the thing is left, only ash and pollution is left, and that pollution will be exerted by the output valve, okay, outlet valve. And to this outlet valve our silencers are connected, okay. From there we are removing that exhaust gaseous, okay. It is clear, right? We have clearly looked at four stroke petrol engine, and we have clearly studied about what are the four strokes in four stroke petrol engine. First one is suction, and second one is compression, and third one is expansion or power stroke, and fourth one is exhaust stroke, okay. In suction stroke, the amount of air plus fuel mixture will be entering into the cylinder, whereas in compression, that will be compressed, whereas in expansion, that will be ignited by the help of spark plug ignition, and whereas in exhaust, now in exhaust the amount of power will be already used, and now only ash and pollutions, dust particles will be there, and that exhaust gases will be going out by the help of outlet valve from there to silencer, okay. This is clear. This is clear about petrol engine, okay. Now let us have a look at diesel engine, okay. In diesel engine, let us have a look at construction of diesel engine, okay. What is the difference between diesel engine construction and petrol engine construction? How can we find it, okay? We can clearly find it, the difference between diesel engine and petrol engine, because in diesel engine spark plug will not be arranged, whereas in petrol engine spark plug will be arranged, okay. In spite of spark plug, in diesel engine fuel injectors were used, okay, because diesel is having a capacity of self igniting. Four stroke diesel engine, in this four strokes we look at first type, that is a suction, second stroke is compression, third stroke is expansion, and fourth stroke is exhaust, same as we have looked at in petrol engine, okay. But except spark plug, we use in petrol engine we use spark plug, whereas in diesel engine we does not use spark plug. Instead of spark plug we use fuel injectors, okay. When suction happens, air will be taken in, and when compression happens, that amount of air which is taken from atmosphere will be compressed, and when expansion happens, the fuel will be diesel will be injected. Okay, when that is injected, reaction. Okay, with that reaction we'll be getting power stroke. Okay, and then after whatever the amount of mixture we have used, that was converted into a vapors or waste gaseous. Okay, in fourth stroke, that is expansion stroke, all those waste material will be removed. Okay, in suction stroke and expansion stroke, in suction stroke inlet valve will be opened, whereas in expansion stroke outlet valve will be opened. Okay, in stroke 2 and stroke 3 both the valves will be closed. Okay, this is what we need to know about this four stroke petrol engine and four stroke diesel engine. Okay, we look at next slide. Yeah, this is the slide which I was discussing about in previous slides. These are the cycles. Depending upon these cycles only, all four stroke, two stroke, all were designed. Okay, we look at this slide. Overview of thermodynamics of fuel, air cycle and real cycles. Okay, generally we have five types of cycles. First one is Otto cycle, second one is diesel cycle, third one is Atkinson cycle, and fourth one is Stirling cycle, and fifth one is Breton cycle. Okay, we look at a clear explanation about each of them. Next we look at first cycle, that is Otto cycle. Otto cycle generally used in SI engines, petrol engines. Okay, with the help of PV diagram, let us have a clear explanation about this Otto cycle. Okay, the right side of this thing, we can have a clear picture about the PV diagram of an Otto cycle. We look at what are the processes happening in different phases, and entire thing we'll look at. At 0 to 1, a mass of air is drawn into a piston, that is cylinder arrangement, at constant pressure. Okay, from O to 1, from 0 to 1, a mass of air is drawn into the cylinder piston arrangement at a constant pressure. Okay, from 1 to 2, adiabatic compression of an air as the piston moves from bottom dead center to top dead center. Okay, from 1 to 2, piston moves from bottom dead center to top dead center, and this is also known as compression stroke. Okay, then next we look at next slide. From 2 to 3, a constant volume heat transfer to work gas from an external source while the piston is at top dead center. This process is in turn to repeat the ignition of a fuel air mixture and the subsequent rapid burning. Okay, in previous slides we have discussed about the ignition of a fuel plus air mixture, right? That's what they are saying. In state 3 to 4, an adiabatic expansion, that is power stroke. In state 4 to 1, completes the cycle by a constant volume pressure, by a constant volume process in which heat is rejected. Okay, from the air while the piston is bottom dead center. Okay, piston will be at bottom dead center. When it moves to bottom dead center to top dead center, then the amount of exhausted air present inside the cylinder will be rejected. Okay, and then next we have state 1. From state 1 to 0, the mass of air is released to atmosphere in a constant process. It is a continuous process. Okay, this process will be continuous again and again. It will be continuous. Okay, this is about Otto cycle. We look at next cycle, that is diesel cycle. Okay, diesel cycle or CI engine cycle. Okay, this is a PV diagram about diesel cycle. Okay, we look at the whatever the process happening in different phases. At phase one, at phase 1 to 2, isentropic compression, piston moves from bottom dead center to top dead center position. Air is compressed isentropically inside the cylinder, and pressure of an air is increased from P1 to P2. As we have already studied that, pressure of an air is increased from P1 to P2. Okay, pressure will be increased. Okay, next we look at the next slide. At phase 2, from 2 to 3, reversible constant pressure heat is added at a constant pressure from external heat source. Volume increases from V2 to V3. Okay, in this phase, volume will be increases. Okay, from V2 to V3. Okay, and at state 3, that is 3 to 4, isentropic expansion. Okay, compressed and heated air is expanded isentropically inside the cylinder. Piston is forced from top dead center to bottom dead center in the cylinder, and pressure of air decreases from P3 to P4. It's obviously right. When more amount of space is released for lesser amount of particles, then the occupation of those particles will be increased, right? The volume of the area of volume will be increased, right? Then there will be less pressure inside the cylinder. Okay, we can clearly understanding that when piston moves from top dead center to bottom dead center, so that inside the vacuum will be inside the area will be increased and pressure will be decreased. Clear, right? And next we are going to look at fourth phase, that is 4 to 1. Reversible constant volume cooling, heat is rejected at a constant volume and pressure decreased from P4 to P1. That's what we have discussed, right? And next we look at third cycle, that is Atkinson cycle. Atkinson cycle used is most modern hybrid engine. Okay, most modern hybrid engines are using this Atkinson cycle. Okay, we look at different phases. At first phase, from 1 to 2, isentropic or reversible adiabatic compression. Okay, from 1 to 2, that is from here to here. Okay, adiabatic compression. From 2 to 3, isochoric heating. Okay, from here to here, isochoric heating. Okay, heat will be taken in. Okay, from 3 to 4, isobaric heating. Okay, from here to here, isobaric heating. Okay, from 4 to 5, isentropic expansion. From this point to this point, isentropic expansion. From 5 to 6, isochoric cooling. From 5 to 6, isochoric cooling. That means the amount of heat which is taken inside, that will be rejected. Okay, from 6 to 1, isobaric cooling. Heat, when heat is rejected, then with the help of atmospheric or with the help of atmospheric gases, engine will be automatically cooled. Okay, or in some cases we are also using fins. By the help of fins arrangement or fins mounting outside the engine, we can get easily we can easily cool our engine. Okay, when we have arranged fins, then whatever the amount of heat releasing from that fins, heat releasing from that engine will be removed by the cool air surrounded by the fins. Okay, and then we look at Stirling cycle. In Stirling cycle, we look at first that is isothermal expansion. Okay, phase 1, that is isothermal expansion. From 1, yeah, this phase will be isothermal expansion. The space is heated externally and the gaseous undergoes nearly isothermal expansion. Okay, and we look at next, that is at phase 2, constant volume, known as isovolumetric or isochoric. Okay, heat removal. Okay, the gas is pressured through the regenerators, thus cooling the gas and transferring the heat to the regenerators for use of next cycle. Okay, And next, we look at third phase, that is isothermal compression. The compression space is intercooled so that the gas undergoes nearly isothermal compression. Okay. And next, we look at fourth phase, that is constant volume heat addition. Okay. The compressed air flows back through the regenerators and pick up heat on the way to the heat expansion space. Okay, it is clear, right? We look at next cycle, Brayton cycle. Brayton cycles are those which are generally used in which generally implemented in gas turbines. Okay, we look at phases in Brayton cycle. At first phase, isentropic process. Isentropic process. Ambient air is drawn into the compressor where it is pressurized. Okay, the amount of air will be drawn into the compressor and where it will be pressurized. Okay, at phase one. Then we look at phase two. Isobaric process. The compressed air then runs through a combustion chamber where fuel is burned and heating that air. Since the chamber is open to flow into in and out, okay, a constant pressure process. Okay, in this, the air which is collected at phase one, that will be runs through the combustion chamber and then it will burn. Okay, and since the chamber is open to flow in and out, okay, it is clear. We look at next. Yeah, this is what the PV diagrams of Brayton cycle, and we look at yeah, before going for next slide, let us have a small explanation about this. When we look at gas turbines, for explanation process, see, assume that this is a compressor, okay, this is a turbine. Okay, how does the work is going to be happen? Let us have a look about it. When fresh air comes in into the compressor, then the compressor will compress the that air, and then it will allow it to flow through the combustion chamber. Okay, and then after through the turbines. Okay, this turbine will rotate. This compressed air will allow the turbine to rotate. Okay, then amount of work will be produced. Okay, and then when this compressed air is exhausted, okay, those exhausted gases will be removed. It is clear, right? We look at next slide. In phase three, isentropic process, the heated and pressurized air then gives up its energy. That's what we have looked at in our previous slide. Expanding through a turbine, some of the work extracted by the turbine is used to drive the compressor. And we look at a fourth phase, heat rejection. Fourth phase is the heat rejection. We have looked at it already. We look at next. Before closing this session, hope you all have a great stuff about basics of an engine and cycles used in an engine and difference between four stroke engine and two stroke engine in this lecture 7. And to get up to date about our next lectures, do subscribe, like, share and comment, and click on to the bell icon so that you can grab earlier as we have launched our next lecture. Hope I'll meet all of you in my next lecture. Thank you.